One of the most powerful uses for managerial accounting is literally that, to allow managers to make effective decisions. And they're faced with every kind, from day-to-day operational decisions to medium-range strategic decisions and other choices that a company may have to make over the course of its life. We're going to look at four of them here, and I'm going to walk you through an animation that I hope will help you keep straight how you have to evaluate these various decisions if you face a similar question on the exam. Now, the first one here is a special order. So we'll join our friends here in the car, and they're driving down the road, and they have reached a T intersection. And the first question they have to ask is, which way do we want to go? And the question depends upon capacity. If we go left, it means we have excess capacity for this special order. Customers come to us saying they want us to make something unique for them, but we do have the capacity to do that. So let's turn left. As we head a little further down the road, we reach a fork. And the question is, which one is greater? Now, if we turn left, what that means is the sales price of the special order is greater than the variable cost to make that order. If we turn right, then it's the other way around. The variable cost to make that order will exceed its sales price. Now, if we take the left fork, as you can see, we accept the order and we can move forward. If the fork to the right is where we need to go, we're not going to go very far. We shouldn't accept that order. In fact, it would be a very poor decision on our part because we're going to drive right off the road. Now let's backtrack for a moment. What if we didn't have excess capacity? We'd turn right. Well, we reach another fork in the road going that direction as well. Similar question, which one is greater? But with one critical difference. We're now going to include opportunity cost. Remember, we don't have excess capacity. So if we decide to take on this customer special order, it means there's something else we're not going to be able to make instead. Now, if the sales price is greater than not only the variable cost to make the special order, but the opportunity cost of what we won't be able to make instead, then again, we head down the left fork and we would accept the order and move ahead. However, if the variable and opportunity cost combined exceed the sales price, we're going to go down the right fork. We're going to not accept that special order. All right, another question that a company may need to make is, they need something. Do they make it themselves, or would it make more sense to go out and buy it on the open market? Once again, we'll join our friends here in the car, and they're reaching yet another T intersection, and it's the same question we saw with the first example. Do they have capacity, or do they have excess capacity to make the product? Well, we'll start to assume they do, so they're going to make a left turn, and they're going to reach a fork in the road. Now, unlike the previous example, this is not a question of do we or don't we. It's a question of, well, we need the product. Are we going to make it or are we going to buy it? Are we going to turn left? We're going to fork off to the right. Well, we're going to make it if the purchase price to buy it exceeds the cost savings by not making it. What does that mean? Well, if we make the product, we're going to spend the money to make it. If we buy the product, we're going to spend the money to buy it. But here's the crux. If we don't make it, we're going to save some money. Now, bear in mind, that can be different than the cost to make it. The reason's simple. If we have a factory, there are certain costs that we're going to incur whether or not that factory is making that extra stuff or not. Those are unavoidable, so they shouldn't factor into our decision. All we care about is, if we're not making it, what are the variable costs, the cost savings, that we would get to avoid if we didn't make it ourselves? Now, if the purchase price is still greater than those savings, well, then we'd end up spending more money to buy it. Why would we do that? Well, we wouldn't, and we'll head to the left. We'll make it ourselves. But if the purchase price is less than the savings we would earn by not making it, well, then it would make more sense to save the money by not making it, and we'll pay to buy it. We're going to head down the right fork. Now, let's backtrack. What if we don't have excess capacity? We head to the right at the stop sign. Well, we're still faced with the same fork in the road. Do we want to make it, or do we want to buy it? But just like the previous example dealing with special orders, we still have to now consider opportunity cost. So on the one hand, we buy it, we have to spend the money to purchase the item, but we will save money because we're not having to manufacture it. But we also have to consider not only the savings by not making it, but the opportunity cost of not making it. Because if we don't make it ourselves and we're at capacity, well, then we can use our factory to do something else instead. And that's going to make us some money. So in this case, we're going to make it ourselves only if the purchase price is greater than not only the savings by not making it, but also the opportunity cost of not making it. If that's the case, then we'll make it. However, if we find that the purchase price is less than the combination of those cost savings and the opportunity cost, well, then it would make more sense for us to go ahead and buy it. And really what we're saying there is, yeah, let's go buy this item. And instead, rather than making it ourselves, we're going to use that factory to make something different, which hopefully will also make us some money. Now, another interesting question that companies may need to resolve is if they're manufacturing a series of items. And during that process, they have the choice. They can manufacture it and then say, well, we could sell it as it is, or we could do some more refinements and we could sell something different down the road. The example that always springs to mind for me is a chemical company that's making, let's say, petroleum products. Part of that process is that at various points you can refine it and then you could sell it, or you could refine it further and sell it as something different. And the company has to decide, well, what's going to be the most profitable for us to go ahead and do further development or sell it in its current condition. So we'll rejoin our friends in the car, and things are a little different this time. They're not heading to a T intersection. They've reached a split, and we have route one and route two. What we're representing here is that during this production process, this company makes two products. We're going to very creatively call them product one and product two. So let's go down product one. As we head down the road, we see an exit sign coming up, and it's called exit S1, meaning do we want to sell the item number one just as it is? Well, why would we do that? Well, we realize that we could get off the road at this point and sell, or we could keep going straight. We could continue to process further. Now, if we process it further, the upside is we can probably sell the further refined product at a higher price. That's incremental revenue. However, we're going to also incur incremental cost for that further development. So it's a basic question. Will the development cost more or less than the additional revenue? Now, if the incremental revenue doesn't justify the additional cost, it's time to exit the road. We're going to take that left fork. However, if we find that, yeah, if we spend X dollars in development and develop this inventory further, we're going to end up with more than X dollars in revenue, then it makes sense for us to continue on. Let's say we went down route two. Makes no difference. Product two will be separately evaluated. Will its incremental revenue exceed its incremental cost for further development? If no, we're going to take exit S2. Go ahead and sell it. But if we think we can make more money by further developing it, we process it further. The key takeaway here is these are independent decisions. A company could decide, well, I'm going to sell one, but I'm going to develop two. They could decide I'm going to further develop one, but sell two. They could sell them both, or they could develop them both. Each one is an independent decision based on the incremental revenue and the incremental cost related to that item. Now, this may be a bit more of a strategic decision we're going to talk about here, and that is whether or not to keep or drop a segment of our business. And you can use segment loosely here. We're talking about maybe it's an office, maybe it's a geographic location, maybe it's a line of business, whatever it may be. So here we are, we're on the freeway, and we're coming up on an exit. And that's what we're literally deciding. Do we want to exit this piece of our business? Now, under the exit sign, it says, all right, if you want to get off, what you need is the loss contribution margin needs to be less than the avoidable fixed cost. What does that all mean? Well, let's talk about avoidable fixed cost. Once we close down some portion of our business, there are certain fixed costs we will no longer incur. Now think of it this way. I have a factory, and on that factory, I have five different assembly lines, and I'm deciding whether or not to discontinue one of them. Now, if I do that, there are certain fixed costs I can probably avoid. Right? Maybe I say, oh, well, now I don't have to pay for the maintenance on the machines on that line. I no longer have to provide those services. Maybe I can reduce my utility costs because I'm not running five lines, and so forth. But there are other fixed costs I can avoid. You know, well, I still have the factory building. I still have to pay security to watch the building at night. Whether I have five lines or four lines in the building makes no difference. Those costs I don't care about because they're not impacted by the decision. The only thing that is are those avoidable fixed costs. So here's the key question. Does this business contribute more than those fixed costs that we can avoid? Meaning, sales minus those variable costs, the contribution margin. Now, if that margin is better than those avoidable fixed costs, it makes sense to stay in business. If it doesn't, it's time to ride that part of our business down the exit ramp and off into the sunset. And the rest of our business will continue on the freeway. So hopefully that gives you a little more visual grounding in terms of how we make some of these decisions as we proceed through managerial accounting.